president announced maybe 2.5 weeks ago a monumental step forward for women's health in ensuring that all women got access to contraception care with no out-of-pocket costs. As part of that announcement, he announced a year and a half extra transition for religious institutions, not churches because they were exempted, but religious institutions to work with them to find a way that we could implement this policy in a way that worked for them, respected their beliefs, but ensure that women got coverage. So this policy doesn't take effect for them for another year and a half. So we were working through that policy, but obviously we saw many, including some of the sound that you were just talking about, Mitt Romney, other Republican candidates, John Boehner, Mitch McConnell, a lot of men standing up there and trying to drive a political wedge into this issue. So the president decided, let's expedite this. Let's just take the steam out of it, take the debate away, and focus on what we need to focus on, protecting women's health in a way that respects religious beliefs. And that's what we accomplished today.
Do you accept that by offering this compromise today, though, it obviously looks to everybody on the outside, you've committed a known goal, you're trying to clear the mess up. I mean, that would seem to be what you're now accepting.
Well, it's actually not a compromise. It's an adjustment to the implementation. A compromise would mean we're compromising whether or not women can get this health care. That's not anything the president's going to compromise on. Women are still getting the same access to the health care that they need, contraception to keep them healthy, cut down the rates of cancer. That's unwavering in terms of the president's commitment to that. This is an adjustment to the implementation.